In this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate the gain or loss on a foreign currency exchange. But first, let's understand why we would have a foreign currency gain or loss to begin with. So if we have an export sale where we're selling goods to another country and the company in that country that's buying the goods from us, they're going to pay us in a foreign currency. Let's say, for example, that we are a U.S. firm. Our financial statements are denominated in U.S. dollars, but we're selling to a company in Japan that's going to pay us with Japanese yen. Okay, and we allow the buyer, okay, so that Japanese company, to pay at some point after the sale has taken place, okay, then we could have a gain or a loss if the Japanese yen appreciates or depreciates relative to the U.S. dollar before the buyer pays us. Okay. And if we do an import purchase where we're a company and we're actually buying goods from another company, or so let's say that we're in the U.S. and we're buying goods from a company in Japan, okay, and then we are required to pay them in Japanese yen at some point in the future. And our financial statements are denominated in dollars. So then if between the time when we make the purchase and when we actually go to pay for the goods, maybe we pay for the goods 3 weeks later, and the exchange rate has changed between the dollar and the yen, then we could have a foreign currency gain or loss. So the way we're going to account for this, we're going to use something called the two transaction perspective. And what that means is this. So let's take the export sale. Okay, let's say where we're selling product to a company in another country and they're going to pay us in a foreign currency. So we're going to separate this into two separate transactions. So first we're going to have the sale where we're going to record account receivable, sales revenue, and then we're going to have a second part where we're going to treat it as if we are extending credit to the company that's buying these goods for us. And I think it's a little easier to see with an example. So let's put some numbers to this. Let's say that on January 1st, the company Caterpillar, which is a U.S. company, they sell equipment, which is inventory to them, right? They make earth-moving equipment and so forth. So they sell some equipment that had a cost basis of $60,000. That'll be helpful when we're going to calculate cost of goods sold. But let's focus on this part here. They're selling it to this European firm, and the European firm has promised to pay 100,000 euros for this equipment. Now, the spot rate, so the exchange rate at the time of, so January 1st, when we're actually making the sale, is 87 cents, so 87 US cents per euro. So if you had 87 cents of US dollars, you could get 1 euro. Okay, so that's our exchange rate, that's our spot rate the day of the sale. And so hypothetically, if Caterpillar on January 1st was able to collect all 100,000 euros, they would get 87,000 US dollars, as they would basically immediately convert the euros to US dollars. And we wouldn't have a foreign currency gain or a loss because they're just immediately converting from euros to dollars. However, we are assuming here that the company in Europe is not paying Caterpillar today. They're going to pay at some point in the future. So we're going to have to do two-part transaction, right? And so the first part, okay, the first part of the transaction, we're going to say, okay, we've made a sale, so we're going to debit accounts receivable, and we're going to credit sales revenue. And what is the amount? $87,000. Now, I know what you're thinking. Well, hey, we don't know that we're going to get $87,000 yet. Hold off. We'll deal with that in the second part of the transaction. Let's finish the first part first. So we debit account receivable, credit sales revenue, just like any typical sale. Why is $87,000? And then we're going to debit cost of goods sold and credit inventory. Okay, and we're going to have $60,000. Okay, that part, that's what they originally paid, Caterpillar originally paid for the equipment, or they're a manufacturer, so what it cost them to build the equipment. So let's not focus on that. Let's focus on this $87,000 that is in receivables, because we're going to have a change, because on February 15th, Caterpillar collects the 100,000 euros, but on February 15th, the spot rate is now different. Now it is 84 cents. Per euro. So now it used to be it was 87 cents per euro, but now it's 84 cents per euro. So there was a change of 3 cents per euro. We would say that the euro has depreciated relative to the US dollar. So now it costs fewer US dollars to buy a euro. So what does that mean for us? Well, we're going to be getting, if so when Caterpillar actually gets the 100,000 euros and they say, okay, let's convert this to US dollars, they're going to get 100,000 times 84 cents. they're going to receive $84,000 cash. Okay. They're going to get $84,000, and then they're going to, let's leave aside the pretend like you didn't see this for a minute. So if they're getting $84,000 cash, and they need to take the receivable. So the receivable was on the books at $87,000, and now this money is no longer receivable. So you got to credit the receivable for $87,000. But if we have a credit to account receivable for $87,000 and a debit to cash for $84,000, we need a plug. We need $3,000 debit in order for the debits to equal the credits. And so we're going to call this loss on foreign exchange or foreign exchange loss. Okay, so that's going to go on the income statement. It's going to reduce the company's profit. Now, what if instead of it going from 87 cents per euro to 84 cents per euro, what if it went from 87 cents per euro to 90 cents per euro? What if we went up? Then in that scenario, we would say, okay, we're actually receiving more cash than what the receivable that we're taking off the books, right? We'd be debiting cash for $90,000 and crediting receivable for $87,000. And then in that hypothetical scenario, we'd need a credit of $3,000, and we would call that a gain on foreign exchange.